نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا شفيعنا نبينا ومولانا محمد معدن الجود والكرم وعلى اله الكرام وابنه الكريم بارك وسلم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Dear viewers, I'm your host Muhammad Musa Raza Qadri from Masjid Hassanain 618 Ely Street, Erasmia, Pretoria and this beautiful program, The Sehri Show brought to you by Alhamdulillah, our group and our entire team. And I would like to say Jazakumullah for everything. And I would like to say thank you for DSTV as well. Alhamdulillah, today's topic is the virtues of the Holy Quran, the fada'il of the Holy Quran. Lots of our people, Alhamdulillah, by the tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they recite the Holy Quran in this beautiful month excessively. So Alhamdulillah, I would like to inform you today that today we have a guest speaker, none other than Janab Maulana Sheikh Hassan Ali, who is the teacher in Pretoria Sunni School, PMT School, Sunni School in Pretoria, and he's teaching in our madrasa Imam Ahmed Raza as well. Alhamdulillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you?
Alhamdulillah. How are you, Sheikh?
Alhamdulillah. Shukr.
Nice to see you. Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah.
Shukr. Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah for having me here.
Jazakallah for your time and your precious time and giving us time. May Allah reward you in abundance.
Ameen. Ameen. Ameen.
And happy to see you. Alhamdulillah.
Ameen. Always a pleasure meeting you, and Allah may reward you for inviting me as well. Alhamdulillah.
Ameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, tabaraka ta'ala, we will hear from our Sheikh Hassan Ali. But before that, I would like to recite few stanzas and couplets of Naat Sharif. Please read salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayka ya Rasulallah wa sallam alayka ya Habiballah. Tu ko ja man ko ja 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 Ilham hai jama tera Ilham hai jama tera Qur'an imama hai tera Nimbar tera arshe bari Mimbar tera arshe bari Ya rahmat lil alami tu ko ja man ko ja 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 tu haqeeqat hai main sirf ehsaas hoon tu haqeeqat hai main sirf ehsaas hoon tu samundar mein bhatki hui pyaas hoon tu samundar mein bhatki hui pyaas hoon mera ghar khaak par aur teri reh guzar mera ghar khaak par aur teri reh guzar sidratul muntaha tu ko ja man ko ja 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 डगमगाऊं जो हालात के सामने, डगमगाऊं जो हालात के सामने, आए तेरा तसव्वुर मुझे थामने, आए तेरा तसव्वुर मुझे थामने, मेरी खुशकिस्मती मैं तेरा उम्मती, 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 तू जज़ा मैं रिज़ा, तू कुजा मन कुजा, तू कुजा मन कुजा, तू कुजा मन कुजा, तू कुजा मन कुजा। जज़ाकुमुल्लाह। Now let's go to our guest speaker, Hazrat Maulana Shaykh Hassan Ali Sahib. فليتفضل مشكورا.
الحمد لله. سبحان الله. First of all, I like to ask Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to bless Hazrat Maulana Musa. What a beautiful voice, Subhan Allah. May Allah accept, inshallah.
Amin.
Jazakallah. Amin. Shukr. الحمد لله. الحمد لله رب العالمين. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعليه وبارك وسلم. صلاة وسلام عليك سيدي حبيبي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. To the respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah, in this month of Ramadan, this is a month wherein each and every mu'min, each and every believer wants to be closer to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are so many things that mu'mineen have been told by the ulama, for example, to do in this particular month. Sometimes they're told that you have to recite, you have to make a lot of adhkar in the masjid. You have to recite a lot of durud sharif in the masjid. All of these things, alhamdulillah, they bring a person closer to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one of the most fundamental and important aspect that we need to look at is the recitation of the glorious Quran.
Subhanallah.
This is the month wherein the Quran was revealed, subhanallah. And this is the month wherein, as mu'mineen and ashiqan of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we need to learn and recite the Quran as much as possible.
Subhanallah.
Alhamdulillah. Due to the fact, there is a narration which is mentioned by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala an. He says that when a person recites the glorious Quran, this is a narration from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when a person recites the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards that deed with tenfold.
Subhanallah.
Then he goes on to say, I'm not saying that Alif Lam Mim, for example, it's one word. Say no. Alif, you get a reward for just Alif. Lam, you get a reward for the Lam. And Mim, you get a reward for that. So in total, you get like 30 rewards. That is outside the month of Ramadan.
So one letter, equivalent to 10 good deeds.
He's, subhanallah, look at the mercy of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is even outside the month of Ramadan. Now imagine we are in the month of Ramadan.
Subhanallah.
Allah, it is mentioned also that when you do an nafil ibadah, a voluntary act, right, it is multiplied, it is regarded as an obligatory, as a farad act. A nafil is regarded as an obligatory act. And the reward for an obligatory action is 70 times or more. Subhanallah. So now imagine you're reciting the glorious Quran in this month of Ramadan. How many rewards are we getting?
Subhanallah. Really, yeah. If we imagine, then we'll understand.
We will understand, exactly, yes. Yeah.
So we must be eager to read and get more reward.
Yes, that is the whole idea.
Subhanallah.
You know, our is alhamdulillah, in this month, this is when the psychologist mentioned that to form a habit, it takes a person 18 to 21 days.
Subhanallah, yes.
Imagine.
Correct.
So now, So now if we practice that, we start in this month of Ramadan, that we try to form this habit of reciting the Quran, by the end of this month of Ramadan, it will be a habit that has been formed.
Yes.
And after that, beyond this, we will be able, it will become easy for us to recite the glorious Quran at any given moment in time, inshaAllah.
Subhanallah. Quran should be recited in correct manner as well.
Subhanallah, that's another thing. Yeah. Quran should be recited in its correct manner. Hazrat is just reminding me of a narration that sometimes people recite the Quran and they're thinking they're getting rewards, yet the Quran is actually cursing them.
Allahu Akbar.
subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they are not reciting the Quran as it ought to be recited. Alhamdulillah, Hazrat Maulana has a madrasa, Madrasa Ahmad Imam Raza, wherein students are taught how to recite the Quran. Every letter of the glorious Quran is taught so that the child knows how to recite the glorious Quran perfectly. So again, we need to make sure. Imam Al-Jazari, one of the imams of Tajweed, he says that reciting the Quran without Tajweed is like food without salt.
Allah. So this is like no taste.
No taste at all. Yeah, imagine in this month of we are fasting, and when you're breaking your fast, you're given food without salt.
Allah.
No taste at all. So hence, we need to, inshallah, make it such that we recite the Quran as much as we can, and we implement the rules of Tajweed in so doing, inshallah, Azza wa Jal.
MashaAllah, as Sheikh Maulana Hassan beautifully he mentioned the narration as well, that Alif Lam Mim is not one letter. In fact, Alif is one letter, Lam is another letter, and Mim is another letter. So whosoever recites, even not even Ramadan, out of Ramadan, this is out of Ramadan, that he will get the 30 rewards. So in Ramadan, subhanAllah, Allah knows best how much. We can say 70 times and this and that, 700 times, but Allah is Ghafur Rahim.
100%.
He can give more than that.
More than that, yes.
Definitely.
Definitely.
And you know how you make guman about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like how you think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you think, no, Allah will give me 7,000, definitely Allah will
give it to you. Yeah.
Is Allah is Ghafur Rahim. There is no short of his khazana.
There's a lot.
His treasure.
Infinite, yeah. It's infinite. We cannot even count.
Subhanallah. So dear viewers, we are very important informative talking, alhamdulillah, discourse taking place by Sheikh Hassan Ali. We'll go for a short break. We'll be right back. Stay tuned with us. Jazakumullah.